Evening. No Dean this evening, which means we're running without a teammate. Means it's going to be a little quieter, a little bit less eventful though. Been busy all weekend moving house, so we're going into this a little bit rough. It's going to be good. In the rubbish, hate it. I'm expecting my favourite for this, to be honest with you, is Matty Chambers, because he seems to have been on it this practice session. And oh, I don't use VR. I only use VR for the odd jaunt around Le Mans or something like that. It's a novelty to me. I love the technology, but to actually use it for the racing, no, not so much. But I do love it for everything else. I've got a Quest 2, which is standalone, and that is marvellous. So we've got 7 minutes till qualifying begins. Don't forget to go and click over to the main broadcast. The link is in the description. First link. They do put a lot of effort into it, and I think it would help them to add the extra clicks and views. So don't forget to check them out. There you can see the main commentator broadcast. At the minute, we're just chilling until qualifying ticks over. There's such a thing as too much practice, and I've been on it solidly now for 2 hours because I just haven't done any practice at all this weekend. I've had to do it all midweek, do as much as possible during the week, and then sort of coast a bit, like when you pedal to like 30 mile an hour on a bike and then you just coast it for about 5 minutes. You got to go up as fast as you can and then just let momentum take you the rest of the way. But first few laps practice this evening was blooming dreadful. So let's see what happens. Qualifying I think is going to be rubbish. Dean's not taking part because he's been on holiday. He's only just got back, and you can't go in dry like that, otherwise you'll have an accident and ruin someone else's race. So he's just ducking out. I blooming love VR, but I reckon it's probably still got just one or two generations to go yet to really match triples.
Daniel,
I do love it. There's nothing that matches VR in an LMP1 around Le Mans at night. Is unbelievable. And in Dirt Rally as well. Incredible. Truly the sort of thing that you sit somebody down. If I was to sit somebody down in this chair who had never done any of this, and I'd put the VR headset on them and put them in Dirt Rally, oh, they would be blown away. So good. In fact, I'll be doing that. Because we're moving house, I'm waiting for the broadband to tick over to the new house. I'll be waiting till the second until that happens. Then I'll get the rig set up. I'll have mates around for housewarming, and I'll get them on the. I'll get them on VR with Dirt Rally. There's a couple that I know would love this sort of thing if they only tried and kind of experienced it. But even so. Yeah. VR has to be the norm, but they also have to sort of figure out a way so that you can happily kind of pass through so that it doesn't feel like you're shut away from the world. They'll get there. They are in 10 years will be a bit like how old monitors used to be, big old things the size of a house, and now they're flat screen and lightweight. That will be the same way that VR goes. Ah, well, Mr. Messer, this is in fact a different league. The Tuesday League is the GT Trophy, which is GT3. This league, the Sunday League, which is, to be honest, my bread and butter, is GTE. So we are up against four GTs, Porsche 911 RSRs, Ferrari 488 GTEs, and BMW M8s. We're missing the Vantage GTE because Aston Martin are a bit prissy about who they give their data to. Real shame, because I absolutely love the Vantage GT3 and GTE, but we're not going to get it. That I'm aware of anyway. We thought the same thing about the Corvette, and although this ain't exactly the Corvette that I wanted, it is still a Corvette. They were apparently really, really tight-chested with... Not tight-chested, that sounds like they're running out of breath. Corvette or Pratt & Miller held their cards close to their chest and they didn't want to give up the data that iRacing wanted.
2 minutes.
To create the C8. They didn't do that with the C7, but I think they've had a change of heart and they realise it. You know. Sim racing cars sell real cars. It's a fact. I was saying the other day, the same reason that 90s Japanese cars are so popular is because they were in Gran Turismo. So who would pass up that kind of marketing opportunity in this day and age? It's been proven. I don't have the data to back that up, of course, that's just guesswork. Right, 1 minute till qualifying begins. Let's just practice it out, that. Right, folks, I'll see you on the other side. I can't see chat during the race still. I think it's going to be 2023 before we figure that one out. But thanks for riding along if you're with us.
There's a car approaching. Watch your mirrors. Stay behind the white line.
Practicing the outlap is important because if you mess up on your outlap, you'll look like a proper fool in front of everyone else. They'll laugh at you just a bit. Especially because it's open quality, that means everybody else is going out in a convoy. If you mess it up, okay, now there's a lot of close times there, but Evo SR are pretty much locking out the top. I think they've had a lot of practice and a lot of cooperation going on there. So if they win, you can't say they haven't put the hard work in.
The end of the session, B6.
End of the session. Qualifying begins. Right then, chaps.
The track temperature is decreasing. It's now 32 Celsius.
Let's see what we get. Oh, this is not good.
Your exit's clear. Don't cross the white line. Clear right. Okay, Daniel, we've got 99.
Couldn't have a bit more room there, couldn't we? Never mind. I don't trust his qualifying lap chops. whereas I can pretty much depend on the guys in front to do it right, they've put the best times up. Now it's going to be me that screws it up. Let's go. Here we go then.
The leader's just done a 157.20.
Got Neumeier right up at him in the tail.
Sector 2 time is quick. The leader has just done a 155.76. Just done a 138.90. V3, only 2 laps of fuel left. Sector 3 is 0.35, left side. Clear left, the guy ahead has just done a 139.37. The guy behind has just done a 139.91.
Okay. So it looks like Neumeier just wanted to overtake us to compromise our second flying lap, because he gave up his own lap soon after that. So yeah, nice. So we're just taking it easy because we've got fuel for another lap. So we've got another flyer after this one, and I think we might have time to, if the next flyer doesn't go right, we can pit quickly and get out again. Here we go then.
We think you'll be out of fuel on the next lap. Box this lap, please, Daniel.
The setup is just really, really dicey on the cold tyres. comes alive after a couple of laps. That's not going to be helping. Still, I'm sure we can improve. Flipping egg. Oh, we're going off track. Nah, it's no good. Okay, let's get out. Quickly then. Minutes, unless the timer runs down after qualifying ends, then we're a bit screwed here.
Your tactics clear, push.
Yeah, that wasn't the best. But it's similar, and it's qualifying. I am absolutely pants at qualifying. Oh, give me a break. Well, we'll still get out there anyway because if there's a 2 minute rundown, we'll have time. I knew it would be like this.
There's a car 12
now. That's not what we want.
New fastest lap for Powell, 138.82.
Need to put the brake bias back for that section, Acqua Minerale, because it's locking up the front right, you can hear it. But then we need to bring it forward again for this section. Okay, please let there be a 2 minute rundown. Oh, we could have improved on that blooming session so much. Oh, we probably had another blooming half a second in us at least. Thirteenth it is. Oh man. Never mind. Blow me now. Oh, we'll leave it till the minute mark to grid. Oh boy. Hopefully we can pass a couple on the start finish straight because we're tuned for speed. Definitely not tuned for stability, I can tell you that. Oh. This is going to be brutal. Right. Untick. Untick fuel. Untick tyres. No windshield tear off. We don't want any, like, 0.00 delay in the pits, not even for a split second. Just not enough practice. Did loads of Imola over the last officials week, but you know, that ended on Tuesday, so Monday and Sunday were the last times I actually practiced on Imola,
other than the pre-practice Celsius, session. 99 laps.
Right, and chaps, if you're watching, thanks. If you ain't, go over and watch the main broadcast.
Stay behind the safety car in the
right
lane.
See what we get. Let's see what we get.
Okay, Daniel, get ready. Green, green, green.
Oh my God, that's real tight.
Clear
left. Dude.
Incident in Tamburello. It looks like Kittelman.
Oh mate, that was a squeeze. Where's Fernando Alonso when you need him? Oh, for crying out loud, we're crabbing now, that's just awful.
There's an incident in.
I don't know if Kev had somebody on his right hand side, but there was no room there.
There's an incident in Tosa. We think it might be rain.
Never mind, pick ourselves up, get on with it.
Is now leading.
If nothing else, I'm really, really hoping that replay vindicates me there, otherwise I'm going to look like an idiot.
Tamburello.
Oh, everybody hates Imola.
Car left. Hold your line. Still there. Clear left. Becca is leading the race.
There's oh God! In more casualties.
Like Chadwick.
Oh shh! God. Taya, you cannot. You've got to be really careful following somebody here.
The track temperature's falling. There's no car left. He's still there. Clear left.
Oh, more! Oh my God!
43.14.
This has been a blooming bloodbath. Tamburello is nothing but a graveyard. This ain't good.
Brumfield is now in the lead. Car right. Clear right. That's a new fastest lap for Powell, 139.66.
Come on. How are we doing for not sure. Okay. Didn't need to lift there, Miguel, you could have just carried on. But thank you.
P24.
I don't think lap times are awful, but my conscience doesn't feel clear until I check that replay. So it's weighing on my mind.
Has binned it in Pirotella. There's an incident in Tamburello. Looks like it's Lobbish.
Oh boy.
There's an incident.
And another.
Marianti Alter.
Just get rid of him, Just get rid of it. Honest to God.
Still there.
Everybody hates it.
Clear left.
Gonna be an accident here and all.
On your right. He's still there. Right side's clear.
Maybe not. Although the car don't track straight, it's still driving fast.
Good in
straight line.
Just done a 142.10. You'll need to slow down if you don't want a penalty. New fastest lap for Lobbish, 139.50.
At least Drew got through that okay. I know he was somewhere in the middle. The blimmin' Indy Autosport. That would have been disappointing.
Is leading the race.
Is he though? Yeah, he is. Blimey.
Incident in Variante Alta. It looks like Becca.
So at the minute our steering wheel is about 10 degrees stuck to the left. That was close. Could feel that. Back tyres getting loose then.
Second place. Sector 1 is 0.29 off the pace. You're 2/10 off the pace in Sector 2. Sector 3 is 0.6 off the pace. There's an incident in Tamburello. You think it might be Burke?
Another casualty. Imola is not taking any prisoners today. This is a rubbish track, that's why.
incident in Rabat-Silwan. Another. You think it might be Jones?
Man, it's... Oh man, we're making ourselves look like a bunch of idiots here, aren't we?
There's an incident in Aqua Minerale. It looks like Collins. There's an incident in Varianti Alta.
I need to put that bias back. We're catching this pack. I think we're going to be able to get him.
Alright Daniel, come on, stay focused. Apexes and exits, apexes and exits. P19.
Maybe not then. Blimey, he wasn't stopping, was he? Yeah, he wasn't going to be scared offline. We'll get him next time. Hopefully he's got higher downforce for us and he can actually lap fast.
That lap time was 140.95. Lap times are pretty consistent. Okay Daniel, gaining on this car, the gap is 0.36. They're slow into Rabatta 2.
We'll set him up for a pass in the straight. If we follow him too close, we'll have no chance.
Now
although we've probably one or two seconds too far back now. Oh, that's good, you got a poor exit in. Although he's got a bit of speed.
There's an incident in Tamburello. Looks like it's Rogers. Right side. Clear right.
Sure you didn't need to do that, Tom. Got an off track, but no slowdown, that's great. Right, can we catch these guys? I really doubt it. We've got about maybe 4 laps to go. Yeah, around about 4.
P17.
Or 3.
Behind is now 0.9. Incident in Variante Alta. Power
window
is
down.
Lead.
Good. Cheers. Tom.
Clear left.
Good coordination. So the problem with this track is that it's like trying to use a scalpel on a road that's got random potholes on it.
We've got about 4 laps of fuel left, B16.
You know, everything's fine, everything's great, until bang, you hit one of these blooming traffic calming measures on this track and it just screws you over. Although that was no hand to be played in the reason why we're down here, so. A bit squirrely now.
Head is now 0.6.
I think the next lap will be the last.
No.
forecast looks good to take 15th.
To go. You've got about 3 laps of fuel left. Good luck, that's your best in the session. Car right. Still there.
Whoa, my God. Clear right. Oh, no, dude.
There's an incident in Tamburello. Clear
come
left.
On. Unbelievable. I am definitely not going to heaven. Let's just wait till the replay, shall we, before we oh my God, get
incident in Rabatta 1. Okay, Daniel, hold your nerve, just keep it smooth. No mistakes.
Yep. That was certainly my finest hour.
Place. That's it. We're done.
Right, first, let's bloody well check what happened here. For crying out loud. So we're coming into turn one. Oh, God. Oh, I'll just have to let the steward decide. Add him to the list. Add him to the list. There was a car's width, but we were on different trajectories. I mean, easy for me to say, but I personally wouldn't have cut it that tight. And what about that blimmin' lap one? What happened here? Just a squeeze. There was no need. Yeah, that was just a squeeze. I expected to see a third car right there, which meant that Kev couldn't move over. I didn't expect to see empty space, so sorry Kev, that one's on you this time. And then just, oh mate, but yeah.
We haven't got that data. We don't have that data.
Right. No worries. Oh, Kev, don't worry about it. This sort of thing is hard, you know. It would happen, wouldn't it? Right. back in a minute or two, chaps, until we get into race two, which is happening in 3 minutes time. So don't go anywhere. We will be back for 40 more minutes of that nonsense. So see you in a minute.
The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 37 Celsius.
Right, race two will begin very shortly. 40 minutes, reverse grid. I don't know whereabouts we are on that reverse grid. Deserve to be blooming. Deserve to be starting race two from the blooming whatever you call it. Amazini got fourth though, at least it was that. I was worried that our incident would have punted him out of the reverse grid chances, so I can always wipe up my own tears with that fact. ...30 seconds left of this preliminary warm-up and then we go into the race. A bit peckish I am. Not had a lot to eat today. I'm hungry for victory. Right, here we go then.
That's the end of the session. E9.
Yeah. I don't want to be short of a litre.
The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 32 Celsius.
If you ain't already guessed, I've got voice chat turned off. So fuel off, tyres off, in case we get mangled in such a way that coming into the pits is a good idea. Then we will do that. Tom Brown is up the front. I don't know what his pace is like, but... Don't know what his pace is like, but he's normally quick. If you're watching, go over and click on the main broadcast link in the description. Give him a quick view.
P9.
Don't want to be yawning. This is no time to yawn. That's the next James Bond film.
Follow car number 218 in the right column.
There we go, Avanzini, who we came together with last races right there, so he's well within punting distance again. Can't wait to make another fool of myself here. Bias is 52%, smack bang neutral, not forward, not back.
Be ready.
Oh no, we topped out in first gear then when we went to full throttle. Okay.
Go, go, go.
Please. Just straightforward racing now. Come on.
Right side. Clear right.
Oh, doesn't look like we're going to get that.
Left side. Clear left. Nice one, Daniel. Good start. On your right.
Whoa.
Right side's clear.
Nose chop. Made a dangerous game there. Need to be careful. Cold tyres. Also need to remember to dip the bias back for that corner because it's just a bit dicey.
On your left. Hold your line. Clear left. We think P3 is...
Oh, just made it! That was a millimetre away from sailing off then. Alright, where are we? Tom Brown just in front. Jensen Adrian's up the road. Who's in front of him? Just us.
P3.
We're all alone. Right then, we gotta get a move on. Remember, brake bias for that corner because the front right locks up and I lose a load of steering.
Lap time is
140.14. That last lap was 139.167. It's such a funny circuit this. For the way the car feels under the brakes, maybe it's just because the tyres ain't fully warm yet, but very dicey. Not balanced. Thank you.
lap 2, Brown ahead is increasing. It's now 1.2 seconds.
At the minute, the aim here is let the car settle in, get into the groove, then get these pair.
The leader has just done a 140.00. The car in front has just done a 140.00. Daniel, the next car is Brown.
The next car is black, green and white, crew chief. Tell ya, artificial intelligence has got a long way to go.
So Brown in front is now 1.2.
Oh, we're catching up with Jensen. In the lead, there's a few attempts to Gavin Benn. Like I said, Tom Brown is usually quick.
You've just done a 139.93. Sector 3 is 0.29 off the pace.
So Jensen and Tom are teammates. That's worth mentioning. Oh, a little lock up there from Jensen by the looks of it. a little puff of smoke, and we're now 2.5 behind. That delta bar at the top shows you the comparison versus the last lap that we did.
Okay, Daniel, we just cut the track. Gap to Brown, ahead is now 0.6.
This looks good. This thing's getting treated worse than a blooming hire car. Oh, a bit wide there for Tom. There we go.
Still there. Clear right. That lap was at 139.93. Good pass.
Jensen is the target.
Don't let this guy intimidate you.
Remains to be seen whether or not we'll be giving Tom a tow down the pit straight. He's 0.6 away, and I don't think he's trimmed out to be quick on the straight, so we'll have to see. He remains 0.6
well
all the way
Daniel.
Down.
This
so
is terrific. Exactly.
In fact, he's actually dropped
the
10.
You're 2/10 off the pace in sector 1. Sector 2 is 0.27 off the pace. Sector 3 is 1/10 off the pace. Gap in front is now 0.9. gaining on you. The gap is now 0.44.
Good stuff. Okay.
Time was at 1:40.39. Track temperature is falling. It's now 34 Celsius.
Oh no!
Point limits. Okay, Daniel, don't let this guy distract you. You need to slow down to give back the time gained.
There we go. There's an art to iRacing slowdowns. And that just saved me from giving up a place. Oh, mate, they're so blooming close.
Front is now 0.6.
Well, let's not be doing that again. We've got Jensen and Tom in front and behind, and their teammates. And this is not good.
That lap time was
for me, anyway.
5:3. All right. Clear right.
Good stuff, Miguel.
There's an incident in Aqua Minerale.
Oh man, the heart is going. The heart's pumping.
Slow in, fast out. Keep the inside line covered. Incident
10,
Bonanza 2. Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate. Right, C8 versus C8. That was 140.35, car left. He's still there. Clear left. Okay, Daniel, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake. Left side, clear left.
Oh, this is racing.
Clear left.
Gonna go on for a while. I actually think this is going to come down to a mistake from Adrian Sins or me. But Tom Brown is not doing me any favours. I can't even just relax. He's right there.
14.68. Right, clear right.
This is good stuff.
Daniel, keep piling on the pressure, he'll make a mistake. Race pace. Your lap time was 1:40.25.
Oh, Jensen, you're quick in all the wrong places. It really is, like, around the lap he's not so hot, but final sector where it really matters, he's got it nailed.
Okay mate, we really think you should pass this guy. Left side. Clear left. Clear left. There's an incident in Acqua Minerale. Yellow flag, watch out. Alright Daniel, hold your nerve, just
keep it smooth. How are we gonna do
this? No mistakes. Still there, clear right. On your right.
No.
Still there. Still there. Still there. Clear right. You need to slow down a bit if you don't want to.
That was very, 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 very opportunistic.
left. Still there. Still there. Clear left, P3.
Stop doing such a good job, Tom.
There's an incident in Pirotella. Car right. Right side's clear. Okay,
no,
Daniel,
come on.
Limits. Keep it between the lines. Need to slow down, give back some time. There's an incident in Variante Alta. Looks like it's Brumfield. To give back the time gained.
Come on, bloody slowdowns. Right, we can start to get back on it again then.
Alright, Daniel, keep Anna under pressure. He'll make a mistake.
What's going to happen here? What is going to happen? A little bit loose there. I don't think we're going to get him on this time. This time is running out. These guys are going to do it. They're going to make it.
40.85. OK, Daniel, that's good consistency. Keep it up. Was at
140.02. He wasn't going to be fooled by that, was he? Come on! White flag lap. Bloody hell, what an absolute battle. I don't think there's going to be any getting past him now.
Keep it together, we'll be on the podium. Three laps of fuel remaining. That lap was at 140.31.
Unless they take each other out, of course. That was. So we're heading to the finish line now. Flipping heck. Well done, guys. Blimey hell. Flipping heck. Very well deserved. Oh my word. How did he hang on? How did they hang on? Amazing stuff. They are teammates and they absolutely... Oh, they had each other's backs there so much. I couldn't do it. I couldn't grab it. Fair play to them. Didn't have the confidence under the brakes to make any lunges. I can say that for definite. I was not happy with the balance on the brakes at any point in there. And when you feel that way, you don't want to be making any dives. So good on them. Well done, Jensen, Tom. Pinnick. You did good. Wow, 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 wow. Good job. Right, if you're watching, pop over to the main broadcast because we'll be leaving it here. Once we've parked up in the pits, we'll be breaking it off. I'll have a quick scan through any chat and whatnot and all, but then we'll quickly be heading over to the Discord where language ain't regulated, so flipping heck. What an absolute journey.
Pit lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour. Box in 320 meters.
Indy Autosport 1-2, they did a great job. Marvellous job. And I just didn't have that last little percent that we needed. I'm curious how that came to pass though when Tom made it by. How did that happen? And then to add insult to injury, what I end up with then is a slowdown, so... See, he had the same thing going on that I did with Avanzini, whereby the sausage jumps you over the track. That's why they're so rubbish, them blooming sausages, they're so rubbish. Flipping it, blokes. Pop over to the main broadcast on Apex Racing TV. Give them a comment, like, view, whatever it is. I'm absolutely blooming sweating like buckets now. I'll see you again next Sunday, same time, same car, same league, same people, different track. I can't remember what track it is, but have a nice week, folks.